Hello, welcome back to another episode of a Minecraft Let's Play. We are actually going to be working on the staircase up to the armor stand area. Get out of there with the horse. Yeah, so up there we have not had a pathway to get up there yet. I would like to make one this episode. And depending on the amount of time, we might work on something else. We'll see. We'll see how much I do. And how long this takes. I do have a rough idea of where I want the staircase to go, which is where I'm going to right this second. I do indeed want it on this side of the tunnel and pathway. The way I was thinking... is that lava around here? I don't want that horse to die on me. Let's see. The way I was thinking was there's a cave up here. Cave up here, if I can get to the cave to show. Here it is. Here's a cave. I don't exactly know where it goes, but it goes somewhere. And down this way is where the path is. And I was thinking, we come down the path right here. Two wide path. Fairly simple, right? Two wide path. We come down this way until it essentially becomes not viable for us to do so anymore, and I think I went a bit too far in with this. I did. So, let's see. The goal was actually to line up with this line right here, so... like so. Oh, actually, wait, this will work out just fine. Like this. I have a zombie coming at me that's burning that came out of somewhere. Okay. Don't know where you came from, but okay. I accept you, I suppose. Come out of the cave this way. Come down this way. Up until... you know what? Go here, but no, let's go down a little further. Not much further, just a little. This will be good. Then down this way. So essentially we're creating a curved path, so it's not completely straight up and down. And from here we'll have the staircase go up and over. Now, you may notice my inventory is full of quite a bit of cobblestone. That is because I want to make the pathway and the stair system out of cobblestone. It's a building material I don't use too often. And I did look to see what it would look like in this area in creative. In the redstone world that we looked at last episode and the episode prior. And I actually I liked how it looked in this particular area. So that is what we are going to be using. I also wanted to cut out this little bit here in terms of dirt, just because it's going to be in the way otherwise. And this little opening here I do backfill quite a bit as well. Just going to get some of that going here. I will have to dig out some of this for the cobblestone, so... I backfilled some of this just because I didn't want to go down a level just to go back up a level almost immediately. It felt like a waste to me, and it really was. Because I tried coming up with a design where it would go up and over that, and then back down, and then up. And it just did not look good. It really did not look good. Oh, but okay, let's see. We got the stairs here, and here. At the end of the last episode, between that episode and this episode, I did do some mining, and I think I messed this up. I did do some mining, by the way. Got some additional iron, gold, redstone, a few extra diamond ores. Nothing too significant. I need the diamonds, however, because I only have like one left or something. One and a block of diamond left. in order to repair tools with and create new ones. And that's no good. Especially considering you may notice my one pickaxe, the one in the second slot, is almost gone. It's actually going to cost me around 33, 34 levels just to repair it with a single diamond. So I might actually have to invest in a new pickaxe. Not a fan of how that's looking. So here we go. Staircase on up. Into the cave. Which I'll put a torch here for now. And let's put one further in here as well. Let's put a few. So we don't get attacked by mobs here. At least not as easily. Okay. Should be good. We'll do something maybe with this cave area here as well. But from here, let us go on up pretty much almost immediately right here at this edge. So there, there, and there. A shovel breaks way too many dirt blocks way too quickly. Oh, come on. Did not mean to place this upside down again. Alright, so we have a pathway up here now. That is not going to be everything, though. Because this is not cobblestone, the pathway around is not cobblestone, and all the stair blocks I have on me aren't used. I have way too many stair blocks on me, so we need to figure out some more pathway stuff here. I did think of some design for this path here at the end of the last episode. Did some testing with it as well. I could not find really a pattern that worked well with that there, and that really nicely came around here. I do have this area, however, all kind of simpled. Simpled? If you allow that to be a word, simpled is what I'm going to go for, word-wise. So we got this straight path here. Straight path here. We have two options to get over there. I am actually going to be putting a curved path in around here to get there, and then one that kind of leads off into this direction to get to there as well. For no real reason outside of decorative purposes. Let's go ahead and break more blocks than I intend to. I really should get a different shovel. Oh, hello. How you doing? I expect to see you there. How you doing? Thinking of how I want to do this. That'll work. I also feel the cobblestone complements the stone brick of this building and that building. I don't know, it feels like it belongs here. It's definitely unnatural, like you don't, well you do find cobblestone out in the world generation, but it's not often that you find it. Oh, I should probably bring this back just a bit. There's good. Put some stairs there. Put a block there and then break it because accidental clicking. Put a couple there and then. And then it's just going to be one wide path. Hello, zombie. What are you doing? Go away. Oh, also we get to see the bridge from here. Kind of look around this area as well. Not a whole lot going on over there. We got the bridge over here, that's about it. If you have any projects, actually, to maybe put over there, let me know. It'd be interesting to put something over there just so we have something to look at from this angle. Because really the only thing that we get to see is my base over there, and that's if we're looking this way, but that way towards the other mountain over there, or plateau I should say, pretty much 270 degrees of this area has nothing to look at. And I would like to always have something going on around these builds, so you could always see something from some sort of angle. And while that is great and all, and I like this, it's just, when you're on the path over here, and you're coming around, you can see the desert out to the left there, and there's just nothing. Or if, like, if you're coming from this way, you get to see a lot of the desert for just a split second, and you could easily come up here and make this a viewing platform. Where you look down on the skeleton that is attempting to pathfind to me. It seems like, or maybe not, just pathfinding around, okay. Yeah, you can easily make this a vista, where you can look out and see all the decorations and buildings and structures and stuff out in the desert there, and whatever else around here. Not to mention you got this here, this tower here, as an actual vista point where you could see a lot more of the desert from up there, and you could easily set the renders and stuff higher. Than the 12 or 13 I haven't set mine to. Actually see out and look into literally everything. It's what I would love to see. So yeah, with that in mind, if you have any ideas of what could go into that desert area, feel free to let me know. I am interested in building ideas for this series. These pathways, by the way, you may have noticed I'm only making them one wide. The purpose is because this building is so small, and the traffic amount is not meant to be high here. I feel like the pathway would be smaller. Think of it like this. Highways are often large because there's a lot of traffic on them, whereas your country road, where you might only have like 3-4 people traveling down it at any given time, only really ever has one lane in it. Might be wide enough for a couple cars on it, but it's just barely. And that's kind of what I'm going for here. It's like, consider this maybe a neighborhood road, and then this is a gravel pathway off into like a cornfield that may be in the neighborhood or something. If it doesn't live in the Midwest, you may notice that kind of thing a bit more than others, but it's my thoughts on it, anyway. So this path, so I'm going to go straight over to here. And over here, it's just going to end for now, because I'm not entirely sure what I want to do with this area. So let's go ahead and put all these blocks in. I might actually modify this path in the future. I might actually modify not only this path, but this one over here, and maybe a few others that I end up building before 1.9 comes out. With the new 15/16 dirt path block, or some sort of block that looks like some semblance of a path. Simply because it might actually look better up here, I'm not entirely sure. I might just be used to the cobblestone up here by then, who knows. But it's something I'm keeping in the back of my head in regards to what it could look like. We also need one little tidbit of info right here, which is this. Aha. Cobblestone up to there. Alright. So yeah, we have a pathway up to here now without having to jump up and down the mountainside. And I need to eat some pumpkin pie. I've actually been using pumpkin pie as a food source, even though the saturation level's not that high. Just because it was readily available. I had 6-7 stacks of eggs, and sugar is not too hard for me to get. And neither is pumpkins, because I had a bunch of those as well. I can't believe how bad I'm misplacing blocks right now. It's just, it is absolutely horrendous. go up here, I'm going to have cobblestone there, and that's just gonna look ugly. Go one over. So go here. There at least be this one block gap. I would like to avoid going up to here because, as you can see, you feel as if you are higher than the building itself. I don't know if you feel that way as well with that, but like here is where the roof edge is. It's just one block above those pillars. By the time you are up here, you are looking pretty much at those pillars, the pillar tops, just above them. Like you are looking at the block of the edge of the roof. I don't know, up here pathway just seems too high. I've been wanting to do this. Bring it back. This way, with the pathway being up here, which you could easily go up here now, but you're further back, you don't feel as if you're taller than the building. Or like the building is supposed to be inset somehow into the side of whatever mound this was meant to be. Also, I need to double take a look at where the opening is. It is over here. Okay. So let's go up to here. It seems, by the way, this pathway is the only thing we'll get done with this video. Keep track of time here. Yeah, this video is actually going to be kind of just about this here. Oh, little creeper. Hopefully you don't mind. You get to see some actual building on the camera here. I need to smooth this edge out here. Hello, creeper. Similarly, I need to smooth this edge out here as well. Don't get me wrong, I like sharp edges as much as the next guy, but it's just so many you can only deal with here. And there we go. That feels nice. It flows. See, does this flow? It flows. It all flows. That's all good. Just to get all the cobblestone in now. Alright, with that in place, we have a full-on cobblestone path that leads from the road down below up to here, up and around, and whoops. This was missed. You saw nothing getting missed. up and around and through and down and up and yeah, to the pathway down below. We have connected these two sections. Kind of. Barely missing the pathway down here, too. Actually, the pathway down here is not too difficult. It's just kind of a... There we go. That's really all I did down here. It's not too fancy. It'll work out just fine. Yeah, this will work out just fine. But that'll be it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, remember to leave it a like, and make sure you leave some details of what you want, or maybe not what you want, but maybe things you want to see in Minecraft that fit well in the desert area, or if you have any other ideas for this area in general, such as a cave, or maybe what this hole could be used for, this area over here, or the area over on the other side, feel free to let me know. I'm interested in knowing what y'all think. I might build a few cottages on this side between the first and second tunnel. A few being literally two. One being kind of like a farming building with minimal animals, just because I don't want them. It would be used as a main thing. And the other one being a farmland plots. So I might, since we have all this open over here, I might build a few cottages of that sort over there. Something I have in mind, anyway. It would give something to look at from this angle and something to see from the road. So, there is that. Yeah, until next time, guys, take it easy.